Love for Sailor Moon. and just be of a shoulder sensei.
I just remember it growing up. It was like. Protected child singing athletic power. What's better than this?
I used to watch when I was a little kid with the girls next door, so kind of got my hook on it.
Just being able to enjoy solo moves with so many people, and just everyone having the same reactions, everyone was cheering over important moments, when the girls found out who they were, when the voice actors came out, or discussing their favorites, when Crystal, when they were showing it, it's just sharing that positivity, sharing that energy, and knowing that after all this time, it's still so loved, it just feels good.
So I think it's a really unique opportunity. opportunity, and I was something I was never dreaming of being able to do, to be in the same show I grew up watching when I was a kid. I feel very, very lucky and very happy.
Yeah, I also grew up watching the show, and in fact, when I was a kid, it was like the first show that I saw that had a team of like girls kicking butt, because I love action adventure shows, but like it was always usually like one token girl. This show, I remember, I was like, this is awesome, they're kicking butt, and they're like, badass, but still look good doing it.
I know that the source goes.
I have an image of Amanda bench pressing man.
Favorite scene to record so far?
What about you, Shirley? I had two favorite episodes, and I can't narrow down like which scene. But when Sailor Venus goes to school with like the little kindergartners, and she's like talking about like, no, you should believe in them. And then she I love that because I was I worked with kids, I taught kids dance, and then I worked in a preschool for a while, so I was like. and then the other episode that I really loved was when you really got to see her backstory with Alan, and that she kind of has that closure and kind of moves on, but you know that she'll always. So it was like, you know, it's reliving that whole like first love thing, and I just loved that. It was such a sweet scene episode with lots of sweet scenes in it.
I think before R, my old answer was that the elevator scene. It's like 5 minutes, he's just like holding her by one. But now I think my answer now, my favorite one to record is the breakup scene.
Oh.
I started reading it and I was like, man, I'm gonna tear their guts out. So hopefully we'll do it justice and jerk a few tears.
So we just learned something more about Robbie. Ladies beware. What about you, Kristen?
My favorite, I think probably one of my most favorite sessions ever so far, was recording an episode in R where Sailor Mars sings at her school
concert.
Question one, are you ready for it? You ready for it? Okay, get your brain cells going. Get your internal omni-channel. And we have Mrs. Clittersops. How many episodes are in the original series? Raise your hand. Mary, is this the first one she sees? Who is your favorite character in the series, not yourself?
Well, Jeremy already knows this, but Sailor Venus was my favorite character growing up. But I think I'm more like Sailor Mercury, like Ami. And that's my answer.
Wow.
I like Ami a lot as well, but I think my favorite character Probably be Hermes. But I feel like I'm biased to choose Hermes, but I just think Luna's so funny, and I understand her getting exasperated and kind of sarcastic. And I can totally relate to that, so I like that.
Well, I mean, Luna has a little bit more to deal with than Hermes.
Yeah.
My favorite character is the baby who pees on the evil alien. You're all gonna pick girls, clearly.
I wasn't expecting that.
Rock and foundation of the show. I really love Umino. I think he's so sweet and he's so funny. And he's my favorite. I'm an undercover nerd, so he's a nerd edge probably, so I'm going to give him a props.
Wait, what'd she say?
Do you need like a nice Christian help dress too, like as a whole package, or
what has happened to this panel.
So, do you guys want to see a special
episode?
Because I decided to be a cool mistress right before Valentine's Day. I have a clip. It's kind of about love. We just showed this. This is from Sailor Moon Season 1 Part 2. And this is the scene that always gets me really emotional in because I know what's coming. And now you get to see it.
So your feels.
Yes.
Is everyone ready?
Yeah, let's do this.
Oh, there's no turning back now.
So could you please give your chicken a kiss before leaving home? And just why'd you bring that up? I just thought, what if something bad happens? You'd have regrets.
Nothing bad is gonna happen to us!
A dangerous enemy has appeared.
You're the only one who can defeat this enemy. You're the god that's been chosen for this mission.
Long prism power, Vega! I am Pretty Guardian, who fights for love and justice. I am Sailor Moon.
Brand new, like just got approved yesterday. Quite a legendary voice actress joining the Sailor Guardians. So let's scream them out for Sandy Fox! Look forward to her annoying Stephanie in every episode.
Venus, I've been trusting this to you, and I was like, And so that was really, really sweet because I was like, I'm used to, and it was like, it was honestly like a passing of the torch thing because I know we were very like excited to meet them as being fans of the show when we were kids, and then to see that they were very excited to have us be part of the legacy with them was really touching. But then I also, before I was allowed to say that I was working on Sailor Moon, there was a little girl there who was wearing a Sailor Venus t-shirt, and she was just in an autograph line to sign something. And I had like a Sailor Moon like pencil bag holding my Sharpies in it, and I didn't think about it because like I just had it before I knew I was going to show. She's like, I love Sailor Moon, Sailor Venus is my favorite. And I was like, oh god. Oh my gosh. And I was like, Sailor Venus is my favorite. And mom goes, would you take a picture of her? Just two Sailor Venus fans together. And I was like, oh, sure. And I'm like going, oh god, please don't read into this. I couldn't touch anything that had Sailor Venus in a dealer's room because I was so scared. And then this little 8-year-old girl that's like, I just love Sailor Venus and I want to meet her. And I was like, okay.
So a while back, I was doing a signing, and this couple was together, and they were not doing cosplay. They were very mom and dad mode, maybe like late 20s. And then I hear this little voice from like behind the table, like, hello? And I looked out, and it's this three, four-year-old dressed as Sailor Moon. And their parents were just like beaming, and I was like, oh, I don't know what your story is. So they met through their mutual love of anime, and their husband and wife, and this was their daughter, and they were introducing her to the original series for the first time. And when she handed her thing up to sign, it was, pardon me for not knowing, the baton with the crescent moon on it, the
moonstick.
And I was like, oh, this is cool. And the mom goes, yeah, that was mine.
Wow.
And I was like, okay. And it was like worn and it had a bunch of other signatures on it. And I talked to him and she was like, well, what we're trying to do is like pass down the things that we love to our new kids.
Aww.
So it's like they had almost outgrown it themselves, but they were giving it on to the next generation. So for me, that was the coolest moment that I've had so far.
So.
Being a woman looks like, or just being a person, like you can be so multifaceted, and you can be too sad, people really love it. Like, nobody's just like one dimensional. So, as the tallest awkward convoy, I remember Jupiter, I just loved her so much, and I shared that story. And then I guess there were girls that came up to me in the line, and they were crying because of something I said, and that was really profound. It showed me that, like, just something that I think is a throwaway thing, like, it matters. And, like, I think us being in this position is such an honor, because it's like, when people identify with us, and we love identifying with them, we're all just like big old hug fest.
I think that whole day at MMA was just so magical.
That was so cool.
It was such a great
day. Sorry for the rough day, guys.
Rough day? It was an amazing day.
Yeah, it was so much fun.
That was
so I hate it.
As soon as Robbie got there, he was like, "What?" I think one of my favorite moments of that was Kate in her interview, and just the hilarious things that Kate says, just being Kate.
She's just so dry.
She's so dry, and like
you guys have the box that you get to see, like the Kate interview. It's just like she's just so dry.
She was like trying to with the cosplayer. She's like, "Do the pose. Wait, you're not gonna do the pose? Like we're here. Like I mean, let's do the pose in front of the Kate." Like she was like. Okay. This is so not Mercury, but okay.
It's like if Mercury were like snarky.
Snarky.
Come on, man.
We're getting how many new characters? We have Sailor Parking, Sailor Snarkery.
The next day. So I'm driving to the rehearsal dinner and I get an email and it says, Yeah, we'll see that.
said the same thing to me, except I did this calendar where it was for charity, and I was dressed in, like, henna, like, you know, like, in underwear, and I'm like,
you were the sexy scientist. I'm sorry? You were the sexy scientist.
Yes, I was the sexy scientist. My dad was like, oh, I'm gonna go buy one so I can take it to my office. I was like, no!
Next question. This is actually
walking down the street.
Finally, I have a letter.
Walking down the street.
Singing the shower.
Peeps.
Did you make that up?
No, it was at the peep store.
Great.
It made me laugh so hard when she told me today. My question for you guys is, if you were to add something to the Sailor Moon universe, like episode, Sailor Guardian, what would be in lights? It's time to write your fan fiction.
Planet X. And it's going to be the world's tiniest little sailor.
To the folks at home.
Really?
on the internet who were not so lucky as to come to Katsucon saw them. Do we have a question from the internet? I know you're a popular dude. Everyone wants to ask you questions. Collector's Anime is actually where you can get the last of the Sailor Moon cards if you haven't picked up your set yet. So if you can hook you up. Okay, all right, we'll wait just a minute, and then we will... Yes, you, sir.
Hi, guys. Amanda, I actually have a question for you.
Okay.
If Jupiter and Sully got to an arm wrestling match, who would win?
Who?
Sully.
That's a tough one, because they're both very strong. Sully. I'm leaning towards Sully, just because I feel like Sully kind of doesn't give a crap, whereas Jupiter, even though she's strong and tough, she kind of wouldn't care. So I don't know, I feel like Sully's like, I have no problem kicking your butt. Jupiter might be like, but we're friends.
It's friendship and love.
Yeah, her empathy, I think. Because she's also, like, she's tough, but she's also, like, one of the most caring and nurturing of the Guardian. So I think her heart will get her in trouble yet again, unfortunately. That's sad. That took a sad turn.
Sailor Moon so much. Where's Sailor Moon on her little cardigan? What is her name?
I know who you're talking
about. Yeah.
I love the Alpha Lama episode. That's one of my favorite episodes of the first season. So, it's episode 31. So fun. It's all
that. You said three rows. Fish bones.
I like breakup. I like breakup of Motoki's girlfriend. Except I like her when she becomes the Reiko Kato or whatever. She becomes her monster form.
Yeah.
She's such a punk. She's like, girls with that boyfriends are pathetic. And then she's like, big flask. Like that's her attack. And she's just like.
Fun trivia. I live with Motoki and Reika.
Yep.
There are a couple. And they're my roommates.
We're gonna make.
So who does the dishes?
Oh, definitely Motoki.
I figured.
We're gonna make. We should make a reality show.
Actually. That'd be really cool.
Living together.
All right. Next question.
Okay. This is a fun question to Ravi. What would Sway Sway do if he was Tuxedo Mask?
Oh, did you just do a Nickelodeon Sailor Moon crossover? That's weird, dude. And I'm super into it. No, man, you guys know about the show, he's a duck. So Duck Tuxedo Mask, I think it was done. That's already like Darkwing Duck, right? That's what he would be.
Would it be Tuxedo Mask?
Yeah, it would be Tuxedo Mask!
Thank you.
Are you talking about moments?
My very first job in Los Angeles was here for 2 weeks as a pilot for Warner Brothers, and Stephanie was my love interest in that show. And the funny part is we're both playing bunnies, right? Because doesn't Usagi mean bunny, right? Yeah, so my most embarrassing moment was being a green, fresh out of college voice actor running up to her in the parking lot and like, can you tell me more about voiceover? And like, I was so horrified about it. But she took my number down, and she took my email, and she wrote me, and she's been an awesome friend of me ever since. So if you're working with her, I'll pop up with the show. It's an embarrassing moment turning into a nice moment. So I know I kind of cheated your question, but.
Yeah.
That's true, Stephanie. I feel like, you know, Stephanie is only like Usagi when she's like in her strong, powerful moments. You know what I mean? I feel like she's the perfect leader in, you know, in the animated Sailor Moon, and also to us, she's just great. She's strong, and she's somebody that you really look up to.
Yeah. My most embarrassing moment with her was actually caused by me. I accidentally punched her in the face. It was at AX, backstage. It was before we went out, and I'm already like, ah, I'm nervous, and I'm like, ah, I'm gonna pass the time. I'm talking to my Jupiter cosplayer. We're both doing the Supreme Thunder attack. I really hard contact with something. I look down and Stephanie's like 2 feet tall, so she's right up the other way.
First of all, who did you audition for specifically? I know who we all
save it, but I did it anyway.
Can I hear your queen bella?
My queen bella? It's probably just like right here. But then I got, what was the other part? Oh, what do I do to my voice? My voice is a little bit higher than Ray's, so usually when I'm talking into her, it's kind of down here. And I toss it to him.
I audition for all of them as well, including Queen Beryl and Luna and all them, and I did not call back, so I did not think I got into the show. So I ended up being Jupiter, and that was the part I wanted, so that's nice.
so please just work out perfectly.
Yep. I'm just trying to think, what is the question? Her voice is, I guess, a little, I don't know, higher than mine, I guess? But not, I don't know, because I kind of talk like that.
Some things have just worked out perfectly.
I also auditioned for all of the characters, and I auditioned in my car because I waited till the last minute. I was going to a convention, and I was like, oh, this is stupid, because I put it off because I was scared it was going to end badly. And as long as the dream of it is still there, I don't have to deal with the disappointment. So I waited till the last minute, and I was like, well, now you're really not going to get it if you don't send this in. So I auditioned on an iPhone in my car for everyone. I got called back for Luna and Sailor Moon. And they were like, is there anything you can do to like amp up the quality a little bit? I was like, yes, I will. I will not do it on an iPhone. And then I guess for Sailor Venus, because I'm kind of like more of a, I think my normal voice is a little sassier, a little more tomboy. I think she is a little more, Not regal, but a little bit more refined. She's done this before. She's the pro of everybody, so it's a little bit,
oh, Usagi, it's going to be fine.
Like, there's a little bit of, but it's not as, like, comic as mine.
You sounded just like her when you did that.
No, I
supposed to.
I went for them all the males of the time. You're a queen barrel too. No.
We were actually the first choice for all of the sailors, but we couldn't pull off the
No, I read for there's only two males available, it's Texas Mask, Cookie and J Knight. And no callback. Straight from audition to the job. We spent some time figuring out the voice the first day, and maybe worked together for like 20 minutes.
Well, not with me, I just happened to be in the room.
I'm pretty sure you're behind that window, putting your input.
No, just the first day of recording with the character, like all the licensors and the staff and everybody are there sitting on the couches in the back, going, do it again, just making Japan happen.
Yeah, and for the voice, I kind of do two different voices. My Tuxedo Mask voice is different than the Mamoru, so the Mamoru is actually a little higher than my normal speaking voice to make him sort of more accessible 19-year-old teenager, and the Tuxedo Mask is like lower and theatrical and kind of like an alternate persona. Good 3 months.
Thank you.